Every other year, Disney hosts a biannual convention called D23. At this convention, they announce loads of new projects for the upcoming future, similar to how they do at Comic-Con. They also have cast and character walkouts, exclusive items, chats with celebrity guests, you name it. But by far, one of the most talked about things of last year's reveals was the sequel to the 2015 sensation, Inside Out. Now, Pixar have come out today and they have released their first teaser trailer. I'm super, super excited for this. However, I do have some questions going into it because it was originally rumored that some voice actors would not be returning. Amy Poehler was, of course, going to return in it. She actually came out and interrupted Pete Docter, who was doing the announcements for the Pixar panel. She came out and she was like, hold on, you're forgetting something. So I'm super, super excited to see how this goes. I'm super excited to see how new emotions come into play, because at the moment we don't know about any new emotions. I know that Maya Hawke is playing anxiety, obviously not an emotion we've seen before in any of the different characters' heads we've seen, but we also know that Riley's head works in a slightly different way because all of her emotions are mixed gendered, whereas like the mum and the dad, for example, they have same-sex emotions. So let's get into it. We've got a minute and a half to take in exactly what we're going to be seeing in June of 2024. OG music. Oh, I loved this film.
Our little girl's growing up so fast. And things couldn't be better.
What is that?
Quality looks sick. Oh!
Okay, let's clear
it. Little bit of Ozzy.
Demo day!
Demo? Wait, what's happening? Ah, who are you people?
Ah, what's going on?
Wait, you can't move! Hey, what are you doing?
All right, she's all set.
Set with what? Orange? Who made the console orange?
Do I look orange?
I didn't touch it.
Orange is not my color.
Not me.
Hello. Ah! Oh my gosh, I'm anxiety. Where can I put my stuff?
A new emotion. Wow.
Oh, I'm sorry. We wanted to make such a good first impression.
What do you mean, we?
Wait, that's it? That's it? That's not it, surely. Right, let's go straight back into it. So obviously, straight off the bat, we open on some original stuff that we've seen back in the old film that was released. But we got a footage of Riley on her 13th birthday. She's got braces as well. Look at the quality of this. The quality has improved so much. I love the use of the Ozzy Osbourne soundtrack as well. And the fact that these guys were all in their pajamas, I didn't realize they had pajamas, but like Disgust got her hair up. Sadness and Joy have both got crazy, crazy hair. Really happy that Phyllis is coming back for Sadness. Are we going to be seeing the return of John Ratzenberger? For those of you who don't know, John Ratzenberger is the good luck charm of the Pixar Animation Studios, appearing in every single film up until the pandemic, of which he has not been in a film since. Other than obviously the Toy Stories and stuff like that, I think the Toy Story 4 was his last film with the studio, but he has voiced a different character in every single Pixar film, and I do want to do a video on him at some point. So let us know in the comment section down below if that's something you'd be interested in. But these guys just, animation's great. They just seem like they're ruining stuff and just making it go a bit crazy and then just give up. So character design here is really, really cool. I've always loved the different character design of the emotions. The only thing I'm slightly confused with is why now? Obviously, I know anxiety is a very different emotion, and I feel like the rest of them could be related to mental health, because I know there's four new emotions at least, of which one of them is anxiety, played by Maya Hawke. Yeah, obviously the parents don't have these emotions, or whether they had these emotions through their teenage stages and then they die off or they go elsewhere, I'm not overly sure. Obviously, from what we've seen, this is Riley's 13 and onwards, so potentially this is where her puberty stage comes in. Obviously, I know we had the sort of post-credit scene in the last film, which was questioning what puberty is, but I'll be interested to see if that is how these emotions are linked But Pixar have got to do it in a way that doesn't make it confusing and doesn't ruin contingency. But obviously, Pete Doctor was the director of the last Inside Out, so he clearly, as the new chief exec of Pixar, has got to have some crazy good importance and really good link to this new film to make it just as good as it was. Really excited to see the return of all of the old characters. Obviously, Bar Bing Bong. Hopefully, we get a little flashback. Now, going through the end, it does flash very, very, very quickly. So we're going to go through a really slow play back. So as we go through the end, we have a flash of all the different emotions. You've got the feel-good movie of 2024. It flashes to sadness, anger, fear, disgust, anxious is the anxiety, envious, we've got envy coming in as one of the other emotions, that's two of the four. Embarrassed. So they seem like the different colours. So we've got purple, turquoise, pink and orange, and we'll go to the poster in a second. And it just flaps through them. Okay, cool. So that seems like it. So if we search up, so if you take a look at the poster, so underneath the new emotions, we've got four new ones coming through the floor. Obviously, anxiety we've already met, and the other ones we just talked about, which do relate to those colours. So the four emotions we just discussed are the ones that will be coming back. A fun way of doing it. I think that's a good way of doing it. We'll see how this goes, and hopefully Pixar can pull it off, because the first one is incredible. But that is it, guys. I've sort of taken a bit of a hiatus from YouTube at the moment, but we are back fully fledged now. I've moved house, we're all ready to go, and we'll be making content on the more regular. If you did like this content, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. It helps me out so much and inspires me to make new content for you guys. And if you guys want to see anything, please leave it in the comment section down below and let me know, what do you guys think about Inside Out 2? Do you think it's going to be a flop? Do you think it's going to be a banger? What do you guys think? Personally, if they do it well, I think this could be one of the best Pixar sequels that they have ever done. But for now, I will see you in the next video. Stay safe and peace.